Na koncu zadnjega versa, versa 65. poglavja Bodhisattva Kalija Avatara, piše o zaščitnikih, da ne bi nikoli več storil tega zla.
And this is also, of course, part of the work. Whatever I have done, I regret, I confess, I work on it. But if I continue to accumulate negativity day after day, what is the point of it? So if we decide to work on the negativity we have accumulated, let's constantly and with the same strength work also with the negativity that we potentially accumulate constantly. With that awareness, we make the wish to counteract the negative patterns that we have by engaging in proper meditation, proper practice, better perception of the mind, better control of the mind, so to do not create any further negativities.
To je tudi, to tudi spada v našo nalogo. Karkoli smo že storili, to priznamo, obžalujemo in delamo na tem. Toda, če dan za dnem ponavljamo isto negativnost, kakšen je potem smisel našega početja? Ko se enkrat odločimo, da tega ne bomo več počeli, potem z isto močjo delajmo na negativnosti, ki jo nenehno ponavljamo. S to zavestjo izoblikujemo željo, da se bomo postavili po robu negativnim dejanjem, katerim se negativnim dejanjem, tako da bomo se bomo še bolj lotili duhovne prakse, da bomo bolje nadzorovali svoj um, da ne bomo več ustvarjali negativnosti v prihodnosti.
So remember that the point of this chapter, the point of remorse, is not to be stressed out of it, is not how to be scared or to be depressed, but to take the right, to generate the right awareness and to do not let our minds wander as usual, creating potential negativities, but to use all the time that we have left to accumulate merits, purify also the past one, past accumulated ones.
Torej, zapomnite si sporočilo tega poglavja. Sicer, da namen globokega obžalovanja ni, da bi bili vsi potrti ali prestrašeni ali pod stresom, temveč da vzpostavimo pravilno zavedanje, da ne pustimo svojemu umu več tavati in s tem ustvarjati potencijale za negativnosti, temveč da izkoristimo ves čas, ki ga še imamo, za ustvarjanje zaslug in za prečiščevanje preteklih negativnosti.
So the text itself has nothing again about generating guilt, but generating the proper motivation to engage into the practice as swiftly as possible.
Torej, besedilo nikakor ne govori o občutku krivde, temveč o oblikovanju prave, ustrezne motivacije za to, da se čim prej lotimo prakticiranja.